is all it was. Send a call out for a place in the soil. Eyes glaze over, sliding the stone. That was all it was. It was all it was. Is that all it was? It was all it was. As I was tired and couldn't find this good between your rules. Oh, but you cannot believe that you're all that. When you're caught to where you finally oh, but why we move names to find you. Calling it on and 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 on. Is that all it was? Is that all it was? Is that all it was? It was all it was.
Hello, my friends.
Lights. I need lights.
How's everybody doing out there? Happy Wednesday. I said to you last week that there wasn't going to be a guest, but that was a bit of a lie. And there is actually going to be a guest, and it's a very exciting guest. And I can see his arm on my other screen. He's covered up with some other nonsense. But yeah, I'm going to play one more song, and then I'm going to bring him on. Yeah, you lucky bunch. There is, as always, a little share button beneath the video, I think. So if you want to let people know about it, please do. That last one was all it was from the last album, and it's about things seeming much smaller in the rearview mirror, like after the fact, things seeming like a big deal at the time, and then you get past them, you're like, what was that all about? I'm going to play a track from the first record that I haven't played on these little streams yet. It's called Once, and it's about trusting your instincts, following your own path. So yeah, goes like this.
Soft exhaust seep still makes you creep. The tide will decipher all. Steps ring sweet, a concrete feet, a purpose that follows the falls. Fight that need to go by few. The voices that count will call. You're back on the right side now. Stick to the sides and crawl up the right shore of the arm. Drained of all experience, you're crashing lines again. Once you didn't know, once you didn't know, once you didn't know. Once you didn't know, once you didn't.
Yeah, where's everybody watching from out there? I see a little bit of that. Thank you for the tip there, Polynome. I don't think there's anything I can do about that right now, unfortunately. Technical glitches. Blame the internet. Hopefully it's better next week. So, yeah, as I was saying before, I have a very, very, very special guest today. I'm so happy that he's agreed to do this. I'm just gonna see if I can bring him on right around here. So I'm going to ask him to unmute himself, and I'm going to switch over, and I'm going to introduce the one and only Mr. Jeremy Dutcher.
Hi.
Hello.
How's it going?
Pretty good, I think. Yeah. How are you doing?
Yeah. Oh, it's nice. I'm really happy to be here with you and share this space with. I saw that there's a couple crab trees around.
Oh, you got the little feed going.
Yeah,
nice.
So it's nice to meet the fam.
Yeah, it's a treat. I get to hang out with my family every week.
That's so nice. I'm really inspired by this idea and this kind of like this gathering place that you've created for like a sort of weekly music and, you know, just time to spend with each other. I think it's really beautiful, and you invite people into your, you know, very personal space.
Yeah.
Well, welcome to mine.
Yeah, yeah. We're just sharing the personal spaces. And yeah, like it's crazy because you moved just like a few blocks away from me, but like, and we saw each other in March, like a day before everything was like, okay, everything's going to shut down now.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. That was so fateful. I remember. Yeah. You were one of the last people that I saw before everything was like, okay. And yeah. So it's been interesting trying to adjust to living in a new city and not really, you know, up until recently, everything was quite closed and, you know, it was like people weren't really comfortable to congregate or gather or whatever. So, yeah, you know, we're getting by.
Cool. Well, I wanted to say a little bit about you for the folks watching, because I mean, I think everybody in Canada knows who you are right about now, Jeremy, but there's some people watching in other parts of the world as well. So just to introduce Jeremy is an amazing singer and pianist, won the Polaris Prize a couple of years ago for his amazing album, which was all recorded in your language of Wolastoq. Is that how I would?
Wolastoq, yeah.
Wolastoq.
So we when we're specifically talking about the language, so Wolastoq is just talking about the river that my people come from. But when we talk about the language specifically, we say Wolastoqwe.
Okay, Wolastoqwe.
Wolastoqwe. There you go.
I'm just opening the floor up to you, Jeremy. I want you to play whatever is in your heart right now.
Okay. Yeah, so as you mentioned, you know, I primarily sing in Wolastoqwe, and which is an indigenous language on the East Coast here. And yeah, that's important to me for many reasons, but a big reason is because that, you know, it's a severely endangered language, and so there's less than 100 speakers left, and so or fluent speakers, I should say. So so we have a lot of work to do to protect it and to keep it going. And music, I think, is a great tool and a big part of that thing that helps it survive and thrive. So yeah, I guess in that spirit, I wanna share a song called Machinut.
Yes.
Which is, I guess just an iteration that nothing ever died, even when something appears to be gone, is that it's always with us. So this is this is a song called Machinut on my first record called Wolastoqwe Glint Duagnawa, which I'm sure if you want to find, you're able to do so.
I'm gonna post the link right now to your website.
Oh, you're darling. Thank you. Okay. Music time. Oh my gosh, I'm kind of nervous. I haven't played music in front of people in a long time. How do we play this song again? Okay. Thank you.
Beautiful. So amazing. I love that song so much. I was that was the first thing that I heard you play back in Banff a few years ago, and just absolutely blew my mind. So it's so great to, I don't know, every time I hear it, I'm like immensely moved by it. So thank you for playing that.
Thank you, Tim. Yeah, I love that song so much. Too, it's a special one to me as well, because you know, that just to explain for those who don't know, maybe that voice that you heard on that sort of, well, it's playing from my iPhone right now, but originally it was recorded on a wax cylinder, and it's a field recording from over 110 years ago of my ancestors. And anyway, so I built this album around this collection of ancestor songs. And that, though, was the first one that I heard. And so that one really stood out to me as kind of like a, yeah, just something worth celebrating, and just such a beautiful document of my people and of our survival here, you know? It means a lot. And then we ended up making a music video to that song too, and yeah, I really like it, so I wanted to share it. First thing.
Beautiful. A little bit of technical housekeeping. My apologies for the folks back home. The gain is a little high on your end there. If you're able to just bring the input down a little bit. My bad. I told you to turn it up. But then.
Okay. There we go. It is down-ish.
Down-ish.
Hopefully that won't be a problem.
Yeah. What else would you like to play for us, Jeremy?
Oh my gosh. Well, I don't know. So many things right now. There's so many songs worth singing at this moment. And yet, like, I don't know. Some of them are... there's one song that I find so timely, and I sing it every now and again, every time I get, like, a little down. Mm-hmm. Because this time is a little hard, being isolated from family, and you know, with like all the like messed up stuff that's coming to light, you know, that's always been happening, but it's just we're seeing it now in a different way, I think. You know, we need reminders that we're in it together, and so anyway, this song is called "We Shall Overcome," and I don't know, it's not my song, but I just like to play it a lot. So
beautiful.
Here we go.
We shall overcome.
tune. It's just sing-alongable too. That's the one thing I miss, you know, like at the end of every show that I used to do, we used to like get everyone to like sing along, you know, and like have a moment of like collectivity and raising our voices and sharing that like vibrational experience together. Yeah. We just don't, like, that's not possible anymore.
We just have to, like, hopefully people are singing along at home and
well, I hope so. Yeah,
putting it out there into the world.
Exactly.
So beautiful. So we didn't actually ever confirm if you were going to do two songs or three songs. So I'm going to leave this in your hands as the guest.
I'm happy to sing one more song. Would you want, maybe I'll leave it up to the host. Would the you host? Want a, I don't know, like an old song, a new song, or a cover?
I think for the folks out there in the world, our other guests here, I would definitely encourage one of your songs. And I guess, yeah, I mean, I know that tension of like, do I play an old song? Do I play a new song? What inspires you the most right now, I guess?
Oh, I think I will. It's really a question of English Jeremy or Wolustigwe Jeremy.
Yeah.
And I think I'm still getting a little too nervous to sing in English in public yet. So I'm still working on that one, still working on my courage. So I guess I'll do another one in Wolustigwe.
Beautiful.
And this one is called, it's actually one I haven't released yet. So this one kind of is the middle, of the middle road, which I always encourage that option when possible, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And so it is a song that I haven't recorded yet and will be on my next release.
Beautiful.
But is actually still in Wolustigwe, and it's a song called Skijinawiguk, and the lyrics come from, you know, when I was doing the research at that museum with those ancestor songs. You know, it wasn't just the songs that were collected; there were also photographs and quotes and stories and all kinds of stuff that was collected. So, the lyrics from the song are a quote. From 1765, I think. Oh, don't quote me on it though. and it says, "Dun gwinu iwog was is kumo swinu wog dum giu diminuj kidak migomen." So as long as there's a child among my people, we will protect the land. And I think for a while now on this continent, we've seen indigenous people standing up and asserting really important moments of sovereignty and that will continue. And I think it's something beautiful to celebrate rather than to fear. So this is a song about sovereignty, and it's called Skijinawiguk. Oh, and it's raining outside, right outside my window. It's so nice. What a beautiful day. Skids in the
Beautiful. Yay. Thank you for honoring us with the with a new song. That's I feel very
thank very you. Yeah, no, I have no idea what it will turn into. I'm kind of hearing like some lush some orchestral situations going on below that. But we'll see. I don't know. It's hard to like when I hear music, I often hear it big first, you know, and then it's a matter of like trying to capture or not capture even, that's such a like a dominating phrase, but like to try to realize it, that expansiveness of that idea more and more and more and more all the time. But it's hard, you know, when you only have 88 keys or when you're limited, you know. I think creative people love limitations always, I think, but too, there's so much else I wish I could offer you and present to you. There's so many little offshoots of ideas and lots of other ways of thinking about all of these songs, really.
Yeah.
I always think about that, you know, there's like so many ways to sing a song. And often like I found, you know, touring often really streamlines us into like one way of like, oh, well, that's just how that song goes, you know? And it's like, well, no, it's always evolving and ever changing. And it was a nice chance to get to play some old stuff too with you, you know, to reimagine it. Cause now I play it different too after being in my house for 4 months.
Yeah.
You know?
It changes everything.
Yeah, for sure.
But I think that's something really magic about music, and it's easy to get caught up in the idea of like, oh, is it going to be this or is it going to be that, and the fact that it can be all of those different variations of doing things. Yeah. Yeah. Well, thank you so much. That everybody, this is Jeremy Dutcher. Everyone should applaud at home, and we'll sort of feel it from here. But also for those who don't know, there is a donation link beneath the video, and every week that there's a guest, 50% of those donations go to the guest. So thanks to everyone who's already donated. It's like hugely appreciated. It's hugely appreciated.
Hugely appreciated.
Every week. But thank you so much, Jeremy. I hope I'll be seeing you somewhere soon.
Yeah.
On a video
Did you say something where you stick around and chat in the
If you want to jump into the comments after this, slip into the comments.
Sure. So if people have any questions, I'll be around.
Beautiful. And you know, feel free to make requests if there's anything that you want to hear.
Okay.
Okay, well I'm going to wave bye-bye to now. Wave bye-bye to you now. Slow my talking down.
Bye-bye to now.
Bye-bye, love. And then there were one. Jeremy Dutcher, I am so amazed and pleased and honored that he decided to join the show. And it's so great that he decided to play a new song for us. That's amazing. I am going to play a request. I got a couple of little things recently, a couple of requests. I've started doing a Saturday night thing on Facebook, just 10 p.m. every Saturday night, 10 p.m. Facebook. I need to slow my brain down. Everything is going too fast right now, I think. Facebook.com/paperbeatscissors, 10 p.m. Montreal time. So it's a little bit better for Western Canada, for Asia, for Australia. And on that show that I did last Saturday, I got a request for an Iron and Wine song, actually that was seconded by a few people, I think. I think it was Abby in New Jersey and Daryl in Halifax, and then maybe Raf in London. So if any of those folks are watching, this is for them. Hi, Jeremy. Jeremy's in the chat now, so like fire away at him with any questions, and I will gladly observe through the screen what he's asking and saying and such. So this is an Iron and Wine song. This is called Naked As We Came.
Mm-hmm.
says, wake up, it's no use pretending. I'll keep stealing, breathing her. Birds are leaving over autumn's ending. One of us will die inside these arms. Eyes wide open, naked as we came. On we'll spread our ashes round the yard. Says if I leave before you, darling, don't you waste me in the ground. I lay smiling like our sleeping children. One of us will die inside these arms. Eyes wide open, naked as we came. One will spread our ashes round the yard. Was Iron and Wine, Naked as We Came. Something else came up on that that last Facebook show that I did, which was I've been really feeling this, and I've been expressing it a lot to friends and family, but I feel like I probably haven't said it during this experience, during this show type of thing. But with these live streams, they feel to me like actually way more intimate and personal and connected than a lot of live shows, because you guys get to all talk back to me in this. And I just really want to encourage people to do that, because it just, yeah, like I think usually if I'm playing a show, if it's going well, everybody is silent, and that's wonderful, but this, I love seeing all the messages come up. I mean, I guess maybe I just need to ask more questions beyond the classic, what did you have for your lunch/dinner, which you can still answer to if you want. And do fire away with the requests. I'm constantly working on them. I have a big backlog, so apologies to everyone who hasn't had their request performed yet. It is in the list, I promise. Speaking of which, there's a Kate Bush song that maybe I'll get to next week. I'm working on it. It's just, it's not quite there yet. But yeah, always fire away with them. Got a Buddhist summer bowl, very good. Andrew wants to know if I ever played the clarinet on the show. I haven't on this one, but the Saturday night one I have. Clarinet's only for Saturdays, you know? But it is here. Next to the birthday card from that my grandma made. Look at this. Incredible. Bring the bush. The bush is going to happen, but Kate Bush, not George or Gavin Rossdale Bush. So I'm going to play an older one. That this one makes an appearance fairly regularly. This is Tendrils. Old rages blocking all calls, hide inside walls, decided to go. calm silence. Don't pick apart its source. Make it up, but just put it aside. Dawn, find us waking upside down. Find your sensor, hold it here to watch it unfold. Frayed tendrils creeping for a hole. The steely gray glow of your eyes. But by night I'm silenced and still. Can you make yourself feel unkind? When you cry out, ooh, when you see who we all have come freely alone. Been misinterpret words, deflect us from the side of you, drenched and afraid. Fight in the sourness that pulls around the brain. It's an offering, again, sealed inside each verse. Up above my words, you've ascended. I'm sure that's as true as any for the times I tried but didn't make the connections, and I'm left to feel. If I was you, I'd lie. 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 Own judgment, picking apart your eyes, fooling by the scope and pull as rope. Own judgment, picks apart your eyes, we barely are truthful to us. Tendrils. So yeah, I believe Jeremy's in the chat, so fire away with any questions for him. I'm gonna retune here. For those guitar players out there, there is the wonderful open G tuning, which is D-A-D-G-A-D, dadgad, and there is the open D tuning, which where the G is an F sharp, which I like to call Dad for Shad. So this is a song in Dad for Shad. There is an incredible artist from Newcastle in the northeast of England who goes by the name. He's called Nev Clay, that's his name. And he just released something, and somebody was asking, I think Jose was asking when my birthday was. It was the 10th of July. Everyone, stick it in your calendars for next year. But he released a video of this song on the 10th of July, so it was like a little birthday present for me, unbeknownst to him. But we played a show together in, I think, 2013 in Newcastle at a place called The Head of Steam, and he really struck me with his songwriting. Like how observant it was, how kind of kind and tender, how funny. He just writes these amazing, I really don't even know how to explain it. Because I'm not good at that side of things. I just say words that I like the sounds of, but he talks about the world in really interesting and funny and beautiful ways. Yeah, my next show, if it actually happens, is in Newcastle, and Nev's playing that show as well, and it's also with The Burning Hell, who were on here a few weeks ago. But this song, yeah, it popped up on my Facebook feed, and I just fell in love with it. Like, immediately, I was so struck. And my management might be in talks with Nev's management to get him onto the show as well, so keep your eyes peeled for that. But yeah, I was really, really taken by this song. And it taught me a lot actually about songwriting and about playing and approaches to music as well. So sorry, José, his name is, I'm going to put it in the chat. His name is Nev Clay. And this song is, it's called Green Leaves. Nev Clay, he is amazing, and hopefully we'll be on here at one point. What am I gonna do next? I'm gonna do a couple more for you here. There's still time for requests, so get them in while you can. Yeah, seeing as I'm in Dad for Shad, I'm going to play Sweetness Follows. I've done this one a few times, but it's just so satisfying to play, so I'm going to do it. It's an REM song. Once again, there's a donate link beneath the video. Please give generously. 50% goes to Jeremy. So yeah, this is Sweetness Follows by REM.
Sister and my brother, what would you care if you lost the other? I always knew this all together. Thunder is lost in our little lives.
R.E.M.
Something cheerful.
I don't really do cheerful so much, but I'll do something that is kind of like pretend cheerful for you. It's a little more upbeat.
Where is my big capo?
I've lost my big capo. Is that one going to cover it? Maybe not. The Spanish guitar necks are a little bit wider. Pretend to do something cheerful. Good idea.
Okay.
That is gonna work, I think.
What's going on here?
See, I'll do two more. I'll do a slightly cheerful one. About becoming irrelevant, called Don't Mind. And then maybe finish off with Grace. Do I play the banjo on a Wednesday evening? I'm getting really close. I was working on something last night, a Sufjan Stevens song, and I think maybe next week it will be time for that. But it's not cheerful. That is like one of the saddest songs I know, so... So, Peter Hartley, until the future, it will happen, I promise. And once again, thank you for all the donations. Link is below. This is Don't Mind.
Strong words, few deeds. Show me what a friend should be. Go again, roll the dice. Show me where my heart should be. Never mind if we see the day.
I gotta retune this thing now from Dad for Shad to Kakur de Geb. Bear with me.
This one.
So yeah, the Saturday evening things I was talking about on Facebook, they are, I've been kind of starting them with a little improvisation, and it's a little bit more of an open kind of jammy vibe. So if you're up late enough, you can tune into that. Thanks so much for everybody for tuning in. Especially thanks to Jeremy for coming in and sharing his amazing songs with us. I'll give you his website link again, so you can go check out his stuff. Oh, and one other thing that I wanted to mention was that because there's actually been like quite a few, because there's been quite a few guests at this point, and I love them all, and I want people to know about them, I made a little Spotify playlist, including all of the guests. So if you have Spotify and you click on that, then everyone who's performed on the show, there's some of their songs on there. And as terrible as Spotify is, as I've mentioned many times, one thing that they've started doing, which is worth knowing about, is that they, if you're on an artist's page, there is a link on there where you can actually donate straight to the artist. They can host like a PayPal link or something like that. So if you're ever listening to anything on Spotify and you're like, I love this artist, go and see if they have a link, because it goes straight to them. Spotify don't take a cut of that stuff at all, to try and make up for the fact that they don't pay artists anything at all for their streams. But, you know, if it can be used to support musicians, then better than nothing. But it means so much that you all tune in every week. And I do have a guest set up for next week. So, and once again, it's going to be a secret. I've been wondering about that. Like, let me know if, I've been kind of doing that for you, for the listeners, making the guests a secret so that you get to have a little reveal on every show. But if you just like, just tell me who it is in advance, then that, you know, just let me know. We can have a little poll. You can be like, secret, or let us know. Put it in the comments. This is going to be the last song. This is Grace, and it's for everybody.
That you roared, storm up ten, the copper beach, the couch is still. We tell ourselves that nothing ever changed so much. I see it all, the grace that you hold. Send me out in the cold, or talk or told, as much as you'd ever hold. Is it enough? As infinite as sin, to cast a stone before you, all of us are fickle and unmoored. At least you're not all the things you're not. Could there be anything that you would rather hear less? I see it all, the grace that you stole. Send me out in the cold, or took or told, as much as you. you'd have a home. You send me out. You send me out in the cold. It's not
enough. Thank you. You've been a delight as always. Gonna post that support link one more time. And again, thanks so much to everybody who has been supporting, who's been donating all these weeks. It makes a huge, huge difference. I'll be back Wednesdays on here, Saturdays 10 p.m. EST on Facebook. Thank you so much for being here. And for being my friends. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.